of Helpful and Jason and many other people that help organize this rally. We're all members of QP Ontario. I know that it's important for our neighborhood to struggle not only locally but internationally. And this is a concrete example of that. A symbol of defiance and resistance, because we're here not only to mourn the loss of our fellow brothers and sisters, but we're here to commemorate the fact that trade unionists in South Africa, mine workers, are struggling against capitalism, against neoliberalism, and for improving the lives of themselves, their families, and their communities. To that, Amandla, which means it's freedom or justice. What is that? Amandla, power to the people.
Amandla, away.
And we want to call up our first speaker. Want to give it up for a Jammu.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers. Good afternoon, comrades. Okay, we're here to express solidarity with the working class in South Africa. Whenever we see an attack against one group of workers, we will always take it as an attack on the class worldwide. And it's for that reason why we're out here today expressing our solidarity, expressing our outrage, and expressing our commitment, not just to show up here today, but to find a way to maintain solidarity with the working class in that country. We're all, those of us who have been around since the 70s and the 80s in Toronto, and who participated in the anti-apartheid movement, are revolted by the images that we saw on the television, by the killing of all these workers. Many of the African workers, African majority, thought that with the advent of majority rule, it would have meant a different type of relationship between workers and between the state in South Africa. Today, through the actions that we have seen since 1994 to today, it's very clear that what we're seeing is a neo-apartheid state that still maintains capitalist economic relations and are winning.
Yeah. Our speaker is Emerson Haram. He's a member of QP Ontario International. I want to recognize.
Thank you, brothers and sisters, over the friends. Amanda! Amanda! Thank you. I would like, on behalf of the QP Ontario International Solidarity, thank you for all the activists. We have given their time to come here in solidarity to the barbaric massacre of the mine workers.
We were activists involved in the struggle against the Zionist colonial occupation of Palestine. We at Labour for Palestine Toronto strongly condemn the atrocity occurred at the Lonmin mine in South Africa, Thursday, August 16, 2012. We were activists involved in the struggle against the Zionist colonial occupation of Palestine. We at Labour for Palestine Toronto strongly condemn the atrocity occurred at the Lonmin mine in South Africa, Thursday, August 16, 2012. There is no justification or excuse for this mass killing by the police in collusion with the government of South Africa. Mine workers in South
Asian can for Barrett, please, in socialist action. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. Sisters and brothers, comrades and friends, on behalf of Socialist Action, one of the co-sponsors of this event, we're pleased to join with you in condemning this heartless massacre of striking mine workers and stand with you in solidarity with the South African workers' movement. There are several things I think that we need to keep in mind in the present situation. First of all, do not forget that the Canadian business class, particularly the giant mining bosses like Barrick Gold and Goldcorp, are among the worst offenders when it comes to despoiling the environment and exploiting mine workers and suppressing unions.
Apartheid! Down with neo-apartheid! We condemn the bosses of these mines!
Struggle is?
The weapon of the oppressed!
Class struggle is?
The weapon of the oppressed!
Solidarity is?
The weapon of the oppressed!
Solidarity is?
The weapon of the oppressed!
Strike is?
The weapon of the oppressed!
class
as in a struggle for workers' rights locally, but on international issues, and in this case, in solidarity with South African mine workers. And Sid Ryan has always been a voice of internationalism, and we're happy that he's here with us, with the OFL backing us up in terms of organizing and building this rally. Let's give it up for Sid Ryan!
Sisters and brothers, I want to bring the condolences of the Ontario Labour Movement for the workers that were so tragically murdered in South Africa. The thoughts and prayers of the entire movement is with those families today. But I also want to say that state-sponsored terrorism is not just an issue in South Africa. And I'll remind you of the many instances that we're all so familiar with, sometimes we forget during these moments. I do recall the Oka crisis in Quebec, for example, when the Canadian Army was brought out against the innocent Mohawks who were fighting for their basic rights. I remember Dudley George was shot dead by the police in Toronto or in Ontario. I remember in my own country, I'll tell you how it happened. It happened because we didn't hit the streets when we had the opportunity to hit the streets. We didn't go after these bastards, and I use that word not very often, but in this particular case, it is appropriate that we start to name what we're faced with here. So my friends, we have opportunities coming up in this country. You've got Tim Hudak, for example, who's saying that we're going to take away the basic rights of every single worker in this province. We're going to get rid of the rancor
of the network, the Latin American and Caribbean Solidarity Network. We're going to now have Jaleel with the Workers' Communist Unity Party.
Thank you, brother and sister. I'm here from the Workers' Communist Unity Party of the Army.
To show our anger, to show our frustration with such a massacre in South Africa. This incident, this horrible incident, proved that it doesn't matter who's in the capitalist system today, who's running the court of the capitalists. They treat workers as they did in South Africa, and they are witnessing such a horrific murder. And we are here to say that workers of Iran experiencing such an atrocity within last 30 years under the Islamic ruling in Iran, and workers of Iran are standing in solidarity with miners in South Africa, and they are the part of a global movement for justice, for socialism, and to bring the capitalism down. This incident once more showed to the people across the world that this is the same way apartheid dealt with the workers in South Africa. And here we're showing our anger, we're showing our to denounce such atrocity, and we are beside workers in South Africa to win their struggle. Thank you.
Iran. He's the president of QP 4772 at the Jane and Finch Family Center. Fellow QP member Farid. Let's give it up for Farid.
Hello comrades, sisters and brothers. Solidarity with Marikana workers. I'm going to be giving just a very brief speech on behalf of the three organizations that I'm working that they endorse this event. And because of the number of speakers, we decided to have only one speaker. So I'm going to be speaking on behalf of my lookout, QP Lookout 4772, endorse the rally, as well as International Alliance in support of workers in Iran, and Council in support of people's struggle in Iran, Toronto branch. And then also there's a couple of announcements on behalf of organizers. It is very clear.
Get up, stand up for your right.
Get up.